Welcome back to Buzz and Sputz in Japan. I have no idea what this means, but you know what? Let's go take a look, guys. Follow me. Ooh, it's very slippery. Be careful. I don't want our cameraman to die.
One onsen. What does that mean? Let's find out. Today, we're here in Gifu Prefecture, where we have the beautiful Shirakawa-go, a place that has been recognized as World Heritage by UNESCO. In that beautiful prefecture of Gifu, we have this beautiful bar. It's called Osen. Here in Osen, women work while protecting their traditions, and the Okami is in charge of everything over here. Right over there, the Okami. And as you can see, everybody's wearing kimono. We will be having an interview with the Okami later, but as of the time being, let's enjoy a drink and enjoy the atmosphere. Right here in Gifu Prefecture, we have the beautiful Shirakawa-go. Such a beauty has been recognized by the UNESCO as a World Heritage Jewel. In that beautiful prefecture of Gifu, we have Osen, a place where Japanese tradition still comes to place, and the Okami takes care of everything. In this wonderful place, women, and only women wearing kimono, serve the customers. Welcome to Osen. All right, so thank you for having us today. There's a few questions I would like to ask you about your place, Osen. First of all of the staff wears kimonos, right? This is not something you see nowadays in Japanese culture or in Japanese bars, right? What is the idea behind this? Like, you know, you could say it's a selling point, right, of this place. What's the idea behind everybody wearing a kimono?
Alright, that was very interesting. So, second question. I think it's everybody's mind, right? I've been saying Osen, Osen, Osen for the whole video. What does the word Osen mean?
私たちは全員スタッフが女性であのやっているんですけど、女性っていう言葉をもう一つ日本では女っていう。Oh,
so 女 in Japanese means woman, right?
はい。なので、女の力で1000人のお客さんをおもてなしできるようにという意味で 女の音、千人の千の千を取って、おせんという名前でやってます。
Okay, that makes a lot of sense. So, it comes from two words, right? The word 女, which means woman in Japanese, and the word 千, which means 1,000 in Japanese, right? So, 女千、おせん. It means that just with the power of women, just women working in this place, they can serve up to 1,000 people. So, it's kind of a very empowering thing for women in Japan. That's why they chose, you know, like to wear kimonos, to have the traditions. And also, it's sort of like this empowering thing of women being able to serve a lot of people and to work just as anybody else. Like, I think it's a very, very, very powerful meaning behind your name. It's wonderful. Thank you so much. All right, that was wonderful. Now, Third question. This might be already obvious for everybody watching, but could you tell me how do question number one, like everybody wearing kimonos, and question number two, the meaning behind your name, Osen, have a relationship with this sort of culture, this bunka culture in Japanese, omotenashi bunka, omotenashi culture that we have? How does it correlate with each other? Delicate, right?
Wow,
that's wonderful. That's very good. That's very good. So, it all has this meaning of empowering women, and you know, omotenashi means sort of giving yourself to someone, right? Like giving your service, giving all you have for that person's, let's say, that's not feelings, but well-being when they're like being served, when they're in a restaurant. It's kind of a little bit difficult to translate, but omotenashi in Japanese literally means just doing the best you can to serve that person, right? So osen and having a kimono means like, even though they're delicate, they are very beautiful, they are powerful women that can serve 1,000 people in one night, and those 1,000 people will all feel that omotenashi culture, and they will all feel that they were very well served and go home happy. It's a very, very, very interesting and beautiful meaning. All right, so Japan is one of the few countries where we have all four seasons, right? Shunkashuto, which literally in Japanese just means the four seasons, right? Spring, summer, fall, winter, right? So what I want you to tell me is what I want you to teach me today is, what is your recommendation for this season, right? It's autumn, right? We are all feeling a little bit, you know, lazy per se, right? We want to stay in bed, we don't want to go to work, it's kind of getting chilly, we want to take it easy. What's your recommendation for fall? I obviously mean food, you know what I mean, right? What's your recommendation for fall?
今は笑いぐりの唐揚げです。笑いぐり唐揚げ。
So it's like a smiling, smiling chestnut. Fried chestnut? 唐揚げ too. So it's a smiling fried chestnut. Why is it named like that? 何でそういう名前ですかね?
笑ってるように栗が見えるから。
That's really funny. Wow. You guys will see right after we're going to get some waraiguri karage. Waraiguri karage. So, smiling fried chestnut right over here after this. Fried smiling chestnuts. And look as if they are smiling. Look, oh wow, look at that. Kind of looks like a peony flower.
Hello, konnichiwa.
It's done. Boar meat, right? We'll have that later.